Hey everybody, welcome to another edition of Lessons Under the Lights. My name is Vince Fabrangelo, Director of Instruction here at the VJF Golf Academy, located in Cordova, Tennessee, at the Vantage Point Golf Center. As you can see, we are not Lessons Under the Lights tonight, we are Lessons by the Fire. And that's okay, we have inclement weather outside, but this gives us an opportunity to talk to you about some things you can do to maintain your game in the off season, especially for those of you who live up north, who don't get a chance to break out the clubs until April, mid-April. Trust me, I know, I'm originally from New York. I spent a lot of winters doing things to maintain my game when there was 3 and 4 feet of snow outside. So I'm gonna give you a couple drills. These are things that are gonna help you once you actually do break the clubs out after the snow thaws, because I can tell you that the feel and the touch part of your game is the last thing for you to acquire once you actually do start to get out on the course after coming out of a winter. So it's good to maintain it, good to do something, even if it's once or twice a week. It'll make a huge difference when you get into the season, and especially in the first part of the season, you'll already be ahead of the game. So let's take a look at two drills, two things that you can do inside. All you're gonna need is a putting strip like this, 6.5, 7 feet, and you'll be well on your way to maintaining a good putting stroke come first part of the season. So let's take a look at these drills now. Welcome back. Here's the first drill that we're going to talk about. In putting, those putts that drive us crazy are those 3 and 4 foot putts. Those ones that aren't quite close enough for your buddies to say they're good, so you have to now stand over them and try to make the putt. Problem is, as a right-handed golfer, right hand tends to want to take over. So how many times have you been standing over one of these putts and you've pushed it right or pulled it left? That is because the right hand, the dominant hand, tries to get too involved in the stroke. So what do? We want to take that out of it. Take the right hand out of it. Now, here's the drill. There's actually two ways you can work on taking the right hand out of it. First, set up about 3 feet, maybe 4 feet from the hole. Take the club in your left hand. Put your right hand in your pocket or down to your side, and then just practice making putting strokes. Okay? That will allow the left hand to do the work. Now, for some of you, depending on if you have a heavy putter, the putter gets a little bit unstable as you're trying to swing it back and through with one hand. So just with the open palm, same thing. Take your setup, club in the left hand, set the right hand, open palm, and make your stroke. So either way, both of those are good, but it teaches the body, it teaches the hands to let the left hand do the work. Because I will tell you, the right hand gets overzealous, and that's when you start pushing them and pulling them. Now, how does that translate when you're actually out on the golf course? Well, you can putt one-handed if you want. Certainly, anybody who watches the tour today knows that there are a multitude of grips out there. People are using all kinds of grips. But if you want to maintain a more of a traditional looking grip that's also effective, here's what you want to do. Take the club in your left hand, like we've been doing. Only grip it about 85 to 90% in your left hand. So all your pressure is in the left hand. The right hand, just going to set on that. Whatever your grip is, if you use the finger down the shaft, both fingers down the shaft, however it is that you putt, just make sure that the grip pressure in the lead hand is considerably greater than the grip pressure in the right hand. So I'm gonna set up like I normally do, put my right hand down, take my setup. I have virtually no pressure in this right hand. I'm gonna let the left hand do all the work. Basically, this right hand is on here just for looks. So there you go. If you continue to do this drill and continue to let the left hand do the work, you will start making those 3 and 4 foot putts, I guarantee it. Work on it in the winter, continue it on once the season starts, and I'm telling you, you will start making more shorter putts and your confidence will go through the roof. Now let's look at the other drill. Welcome back. Let's do drill number two. Here's what we need. We need a golf club, doesn't matter. It doesn't even have to be a golf club. It could be a broom handle, it could be a box, it could be anything you want it to be. You're gonna set that down, it's gonna become almost like a wall, okay? You're going to set the putter down next to the ball so that the toe of the club is basically touching the shaft of the club laying on the ground. As we putt, we're going to want to keep that putter on the shaft all the way back and all the way through. The more this club comes away from the shaft, the more our stroke is not straight back, straight through. Now there are two types of putting strokes, and it depends on which putting stroke that you subscribe to if this drill is going to work for you. If you're a straight back, straight through putter, this is going to work, because you want to keep the toe of the putter on this wall, which is simulated by the club, all the way back and all the way through. If you are an arc putter, where the club moves on a slight arc, then the club is going to move away from the shaft a little as you make your putting stroke. We will talk in the future about drills that will help that particular putting stroke. But if you're a straight back, straight through putter, this is going to be a great drill to give you instant feedback. So I'm going to get set up to the ball. I'm going to set the tip of my putter right along my imaginary wall, which is really not imaginary, it's a golf club. I'm going to take my setup, and I'm going to try to keep the toe of my putter very close to that imaginary wall. And again, that will allow to give you instant feedback to see if your club is coming off your track. So both of these will help you immensely once you get into the season, because like anything, the more you practice, the more it becomes permanent, as long as you're doing it correctly. So do this once or twice a week during the off season. When the season gets here, this stuff will be almost automatic, and I guarantee you'll be making more putts, both short putts, even longer putts, because your stroke is going to be much more consistent. I hope this has helped. If you have trouble with your putting, give these a try. As I always say, don't change just to change. But if you're looking for something, you're looking for a change, looking for something to help you save a few strokes, this might be the drill or the drills that'll help you. So thanks for stopping in. Join us again. We're going to be adding more videos. But for now, thanks for visiting.